Es sind dann der Prof von Luxemburgisch with Anne. Now, a lot of my students get confused when I say something and they want to agree with it. And then they are often stuck, they don't remember, shall I say ich auch, or mich auch, or mir auch? In English, it is easy to agree with somebody, whether someone is saying, I'm cold, or I'm hungry, or I like you. You can always answer with me too. But in Luxembourgish, it's not as easy. You have three possibilities. You can answer with ich auch, mich auch, and mir auch. And now I hear you asking, but Anne, how shall I know when I should use which one? Well, let me explain you this in this short lesson. Warst du bereit? Are you ready? Dann los! Let's start with ich auch. Pronounce it ich auch. Now, ich auch means me too, but this is in the nominative case. This means that ich is the subject. So whenever someone says to you, for example, ich sind daheim, you can answer ich auch, because he said ich sind daheim, ich auch. Or someone says ich sind hungrig, you can answer ich auch. Or ich wohne an der Stadt, ich auch. Ich mache all der Sport, ich auch. Great, easy, isn't it? Let's move on with mir auch. Mir auch means to me too. So this is in the dative case, meaning that mir is either the indirect object in the sentence or it comes after a dative preposition. For example, to say in Luxembourgish I'm cold, you say et as mir kal. Et as mir kal. So mir is the indirect object. And then you answer by saying mir auch. Okay? Or another example with a verb which requires the dative case, hin hilft mir. Okay, so mir is the indirect object, so you will say as well mir auch. Okay, or Buch gefällt mir, mir auch. Okay, let's have an example with a preposition. Hat das oft bei mir. Hat as oft bei mir. Bei is the preposition. And then you can say bei mir auch. So if someone says to you, hat as oft bei mir auch. Whenever you use a dative preposition, you will have to add it to your answer. For example, if someone says, je geht mit mir an the Kino, you have to answer mit mir auch, because mit is a dative preposition. Or another one is von mir auch, or bei mir auch. But be careful, bei is a two-way preposition. Okay, now let's move on with mich auch. Now, mich auch means as well me too, but here in the accusative case, meaning that mich is the direct object or it comes after an accusative preposition. Let's have some examples. Hat Fried mich oft etwas? Mich auch. Hat Fried mich oft etwas? Mich auch. Or often someone says to you, dat freut mich, that pleases me. Then you can say, mich auch, dat freut mich, mich auch. Let's have an example with a preposition. Dat war für mich. So, für here is the accusative preposition. And then you say, für mich, dat war für mich. And then you can say, für mich auch, für mich auch. Or another example with a preposition, macht dat ohne mich. Ohne is an accusative preposition, so you have to say ohne mich. Macht dat ohne mich. Ohne mich auch. So here again, whenever you use an accusative preposition, you will have to add this preposition to your answer. So for example, ohne mich hier mösch auch. Okay. Let's finish this short lesson with a remark. Whenever you use a reflexive verb like sich frieren oder sich waschen, you will have as well to answer by mösch auch or mir auch. But be careful, here the mösch or the mir will be the reflexive pronoun. Example, ich friere mich, dat Haut scheint wieder aus. And then you can answer by saying ich mich auch. Because here ich is the subject. Huh? Ich friere mich, dat Haut scheint wieder aus. Ich mich auch. Oder ich wasche mir lo tan. Ich mir auch. Great. Now, I hope that this lesson was helpful. And you can read the full transcript of this lesson on my blog. And you can as well practice on my blog with an exercise, a translation exercise. Well, great. Thank you for watching. Merci fürs Zugucken. Adi.